Hey YouTube, Kira Qualia here, bringing you all an update to my Cardfight Vanguard Machining Mega Colonies standard deck profile for post Phantom Dragon Aeon. With the release of Phantom Dragon Aeon, we were given even more machining support, with which each Mega Colony set we've gotten so far, they gave us, you know, little bits and pieces here of different machining support, which in the beginning with cards like Machining Spark, Hercules, and Stag Beetle, they were a main focus on just the generic Mega Colony decks, focusing more on those generic plays you could do with your cards. But with the more and more machining cards we receive, they more, you know, specifically went to the playstyle of working with all the different machining cards. So I figured a deck profile that focuses on machining was definitely needed for the update, since we got a lot of good support in this new set to help with the overall playstyle of the machining deck. So let's go ahead and get started with the deck profile. So we're running a pretty high grade 3 count in the deck. I'm running 4 Machining Spark Hercules, one of our boss monsters to go into on Vanguard Circle once per turn. Counterblast 2. Choose up to 5 of your rearguards, stand them, and they get plus 5,000 power until end of turn. Choose all of your opponent's rearguards and rest them, and they get minus 5,000 power. So not only does it basically affect their rearguards, it also affects their Vanguard since it's units. And also, with that minus 5,000 power, they could be heavily weakened and, you know, have to rely more on their force 1 markers, their force 2 for the additional critical, but still not might be able to hit against your units. But the excel 1 and excel 2 for those boosted cards, since this card also chooses all of your opponent's unit, will hit those additional excel marker circles also. And on Vanguard, once per turn, put a grade 2 or less rear guard into your soul, and this unit gets plus 5,000 power until end of turn for each of your opponent's rest units. So with this, you have the power boost to hit over your opponent's Vanguard after it took the blow of being lowered in power with its first ability, but being able to boost this card up so it might not even need the boost power from some of your other cards makes it that much better for sure as your go-to boss monster in the deck. For the additional backup card from the new set, I'm running 4 Machining Meteor Bullet on Vanguard or rear. If you have 5 or more rear guards, all of your rear guards with machining in their card name gain boost. So we run a pretty high grade 3 count in the deck. So being able to give those grade 3s the boost ability, they won't be really much needed for intercept. We'll want to keep the grade 2s in the front row for that. But being able to put them in the back row for boosting makes it that much better of a card, especially this card on rear guard while your main go-to unit, Spark Hercules, is on your Vanguard circle. And on Vanguard or rear, once per turn, you can rest one other rear guard with machining its card name, and this unit gets plus 10,000 power until end of turn. So not only can you rest another, let's say, rear guard you have on the field to boost this card's power up, but then when you have Spark Hercules on your Vanguard, you can put another grade 2 or less into your soul to stand all of your units on the field as well for the counterblast, standing all of them. So then you'll have this option for these cards to be restood and have the other Meteor Bullet with your power on the field already from resting the other card on the field. So we want 4 of this card, just a great backup rear guard for sure, but it can also work on Vanguard if need be with those plays. And I also run 2 Machining Stag Beetle on Vanguard or rear when placed from hand. Call up to 2 cards from your soul to rear as rest. And if this unit was placed on Vanguard, this unit gets the original power of all of those units called with this card. So calling them to rest is really not that big a deal because you can restand them with your Spark Hercules, but more and more resources with this card. You'll build up your soul with plenty of other machining units that you ride and then just be able to call them back out onto the field at rest. But once again, you can restand them and then they'll have their chance to attack after being restood with Spark Hercules. And then just more and more set up with either putting cards into the soul to call out with Spark Hercules and then calling them out with Stag Beetle, or even just being able to set up your machining so they have boosts depending on which one you may call out also. And then to finish off the grade 3s, I run 2 Machining Centipede on Vanguard or rear, counterblast 1. Choose the same number of your opponent's units as the number of your rest rear guards, and until the end of your opponent's next turn, they lose twin drive, intercept, and boost, and they cannot gain those skills and stand this unit. So with this card, it's just all that pressure. You made your Spark Hercules have them lose power. It also, they were basically taken away by having their abilities nullified with this card. losing Twin Drive, because you can also choose your opponent's Vanguard. So if they don't ride into another card, they're going to have a severely weakened Vanguard. They're going to have one without Twin Drive. Their grade twos will lose Intercept, which would definitely not benefit them during your turn. And if they don't have, and if they have boost, basically, they won't be able to do anything from the back row for your opponent, not even be able to rest them to boost your other units. So great backup for sure. The fact that this card also works on Vanguard rear makes it all the better for sure for Restand, because then you can rest it with your Machining Meteor Bullet, resting this card, giving the power boost, then using its own skill to restand it, along with taking away a good number of cards from your opponent's field. And that is it for the grade threes. We'll now move on to the grade twos for one of our best searchers in the deck. It's Machining Mantis. On Vanguard or rear, when placed, Scatterblast 1. Look at 6 cards from the top of your deck. Reveal up to 1 grade 3 card from among them. Put it into your hand, and this unit gets plus 6,000 power. So we got plenty of grade threes to search out for in this deck. Just having that option and, you know, maybe having one particular one in our hand, but needing a specific one for the play we want to go for, relying on Machining Mantis as a Vanguard ride target, or even just calling it to rear guard, even calling it with this card, being able to call it out with Stag Beetle makes it all the better, because then you can use the Counterblast skill. It doesn't specify being called from hand, it just says when placed. You can search more and more grade threes and then have ride target after ride target, or just more and more rear guards to call for your plays also. And also, one of our best cards we got from the Phantom Dragon Aeon set. That is Machining Scatterhorn on Vanguard or rear, when placed from hand. Look at 6 cards on the top of your deck. Reveal up to 1 non-grade 2 card with Machining from among them. Put it to your hand. Shuffle your deck. If you put a card into your hand, put a card from your hand to your soul. So not only will putting it into the soul set it up for Stag Beetle if you call this card out, being able to use this card on Vanguard or rear is more search power. You can't search a grade 2, but you can still search grade 3s or even grade 1s with this card. So having more and more Machining cards to use in your hand with this one makes it all the better. And also on Vanguard or rear, once per turn, Soul Blast and rest a rear guard with Machining its card name. Choose one of your opponent's rear guards, and that unit cannot stand during their opponent's next stand phase. So you will shut down with power boosts, you will shut down with them losing their abilities, but the one thing to completely lock them down is Scatterhorn, making it so they can't even stand next turn. It is the paralyze skill that Mega Colony has been using for quite a while, and, you know, being reused again in this deck for the Machining deck, added that one power step that they were missing with all their other cards. They had the power boost, they had the rear guard setup, but Scatterhorn helps with that final thing that Mega Colony goes for, and that is paralyze. And then those are the only, sadly, the only Machining grade twos we have for standard format. So for the last spot, I decided to go with one of the newer cards from the Phantom Dragon Aeon set, being Battering Mutant Old Jewel. It is not a Machining, so you won't be able to benefit from those cards, but just having an additional grade two rear guard with 12,000 power to swing into your opponent is just a good resource to rely on. Even if you ride this card as a ride target, and then also not being limited with the placed effects of your other cards, you just won't be able to call it out with Stag Beetle for the full benefit. But Stag Beetle also isn't limited to what cards it calls out from the soul, so remember that. It's more of the generic earlier Machining cards we have, so you have that option with Old Jewel if you do choose this as your ride target. And that is it for the grade twos. We'll now move on to the grade ones. Running 4 Machining Hornet on Vanguard or rear, when it attacks or the attack that it boosted hits a Vanguard, look at 6 cards from the top of your deck. Reveal up to 1 grade 3 from among them. Put it into your hand and shuffle your deck. If you put it into your hand and this card is on rear guard, you put this card into the soul. So putting it into the soul, once again, you'll just be able to call it back out with Stag Beetle. But if it's on your Vanguard circle and you attack first, that's more pressure against your opponent because they're giving you a grade 3 search if they let this card hit. And it doesn't cost any counterblast, it just has to hit or boost. So that much better, and definite 4 of in the deck, being another Machining card to use. I'm also running 4 of the new Machining Psy Bister with this one. On rear, when rest by your card's ability, look at 3 cards on the top of your deck. Call up to 1 card with Machining and its card name from among them to rear, and put the rest on the bottom of your deck. This ability may only be used by a card with the same name once a turn. So if you have plenty of your setup with your Machining Meteor Bullet, you can rest your Psy Bister, and then giving this card the plus 10, and then being able to check the top 3 of your deck for another Machining card to add to your hand to use. It's that much more search power. You're basically utilizing this card for the search, but once again, it's a once per turn, but I still like to run the 4, so we have the option to see this search play more and more in the deck. And then lastly, for the grade ones, I'm running two of the new promo Powdery Die Lady on rearguard when placed from hand during your main phase. Stand one of your other rest rearguards, and this unit, that unit gets plus 5,000 to end of turn. So it's not a machining unit, but still, with all the resting we do in the deck, especially early game, if we don't have the means, like Spark Hercules, to restand those cards, these cards like Powdery Die Lady really do come in handy for that restand power and the additional power boost they can provide to your units. And also, that's it for the grade ones. Moving on to the grade zeros, I run one machining worker ant. Not only does it have the quick order shield and the draw power when rode upon, but with this card being in your soul, it is a potential call for your machining stag beetle, calling this card out to the field at rest, but also being able to utilize it being a machining card with your meteor bullet, giving you one more additional rear guard to call out. So when you set this card up in your soul for the ride, you're slowly building it up to the potential that you can call it out for that one additional machining rear guard to use. So you definitely want to run this starter. We have plenty of other different machining, machining mega colony starters, but you want to use worker ant for sure, just to have this search power and potential rear guard to call out. For the trigger lineup, I decided to stick with the 8 criticals, so the 4 Jeweler Flash and the 4 Sharpnail Scorpio. More pressure, especially when we lower our opponent's units and just attack with Spark Hercules. Being able to hit for big numbers and also for that critical pressure really does help. But I still run the 4 Paralyzed Madonna because I do like the draw triggers to rely on and the guaranteed block of Sentinel attacks against your opponent. And lastly, the 4 Medical Battler for the heal trigger spot, just my preferred art. The other one seems more of a Gridora heal, so this one feels more of the machining one. We don't have a machining heal for standard, but still a great one to rely on for sure. But that is it for the deck profile. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Definitely going to be working on the Gridora deck as well for Mega Colony from the newest set. So look forward to that sometime in the future as well. I've just always been a big fan of machining, so wanted to do a deck profile for this deck for sure. But until next time, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. And Kira Qualia out.